Upon close examination, we can see here an ET, a gray, a UFO, yeah, and Frankenstein. Lots of gray material, yes, in this with the alien. Okay, the line. And what is very curious is that in the last page, no, a frog, which is a demonic spirit in general, the three frogs in Apocalypse representing demonic spirits that will possess the beasts, the false prophet, the antichrist, and the Bible upside down. So this is very interesting what they are doing with the Word of God. And the message is for the children, of course, how they are indoctrinating and how they are distorting this majestic work, the greatest self-help book, the greatest of the greatest books that anyone should read. And I just cannot get over the thought that whenever I started, why I didn't feel that hunger, why I didn't feel that thirst, why I didn't feel, when I just knew it was so real, so beautiful, I was finding amazing things. Why? Because the church, the apostasy, the false apostles had created a lot of confusion, doubt, and made me hesitant to trust the Word of God. And there were no elders to trust, to encourage that walk. And it's just another sign, like the dream with the two little hearts, the two little hearts. So this is the confirmation, like with the dream with the two little hearts. Speak up, speak up, speak up. It doesn't matter who listens. What matters is that you give your testimony. And it's so difficult to trust that you have a good testimony, that you, I don't know, I have been really this year, more than ever before, very aware of the effects and the traumatic effects of abortions and being born after two abortions. The first one and then the second one, my grandmother actually seen that because it was illegal in Colombia at that time. She sent my father to jail. And perhaps because of that, serious kind of situation, they decided to have me. But truly, just checking videos from so many great people of God, you really understand that there are forces and generational curses that only the blood of Jesus really, truly, truly, truly has healed and restored. He has washed us away, but still, it's just so incredible to feel so inadequate, so lacking confidence. That's the core issue, that you really, that I can be good enough to do it, and I just have to trust these signs and the way God's language is expressed, because he talks to little signs like these. He talks through a sermon, sometimes in dreams, sometimes in a vision, sometimes just words before waking up, sometimes. But thank you for your prayers, because we have felt anyway that little things, little signs like this truly help us to sing our song before, not to die with our songs inside, something like that. There is a saying that is so beautiful, don't die without singing your song, or something like that. So it was touching to find this, because Richard has gone around before parking, and he was doing a few things around the co-pilot's door. It was not there, but whenever we came back together to pick up the car, it was there. So just to wash away, and so many false apostles and false evangelists and false people of God, false preachers and ministries giving this kind of information. And really, it is about helping the baby Christians with whatever our testimony is. Thank you for your prayers, thank you for everything you have done, and to encourage you as well in your signs, and asking the Holy Spirit to keep reminding us, teaching us, and guiding us to all truth, and giving us the confidence on the identity that we have in Christ, who we are as children of the Most High. No weapon formed against us shall prosper. Amen.